Good afternoon, everyone. It's scheduled for all the research scholars, and I am really feeling privileged to introduce my discipline, economics, and then later I will also talk about theory of demand, which is the topic of this lecture. So let's delve little into the meaning of economics. What economics basically means. My this lecture is actually very basic level, because what I'm trying to do is that I'm trying to introduce economics as a discipline to all the research scholar from each discipline, considering that each discipline of research scholar from each discipline of Pune University have joined me for this lecture. So let's start with looking at economics as a discipline, as a pedagogic discipline. So, if we look at economics as a pedagogic discipline, means the subject which we are teaching, and it's a trait of learning. So, we can divide those learning theories or concepts into three kinds of theories: theories of production, theories of consumption, and theories of exchange. So this is the nutshell of the idea of economics as a pedagogic skill. Then we can look at economics as a real skill, the sort of skill which we do as an economic agent, which we perform as an economic agent in the market. What is, again, the question, what is market? Market is an institution. Institution basically means that the place where there are some laws, and that is, those laws need to be necessarily be followed. Okay, so this economics as a real skill is basically all about economic agents, those agents who are participating in the market process, in the process of exchange. The properties of each of these economic agents are varied kind, capitalist gets motivated with profit maximization, and producer gets motivated into cost minimization, consumer gets motivated to utility maximization. So this is what, these are the features of these economic agents, if we look at economy as a real skill. Moving on, economics can be looked at as a science of choice and change. What do we mean by the science of choice and change? Is that how you make choices, and what is basically your choice making strategy? So economics, in a way, is also a decision making, a science looking into your decision making process, how you make a strategy, how you decide to choose something. So you can say that it's a way, economics could be looked at as a way of thinking through which we basically try to understand the real world. Okay, then the second, how do you make choices, and what is your choice making strategy? And then second one is how you change your choices. Let's say you have made a choice, and then you have switched to other choice. So basically, switching of your choice is the second important ingredient of inquiry for the subject of economics. Moving on, so this is what a small introduction which I was trying to convey you with this course introduction to economics. Moving on to the topic of today, which is theory of demand. So theory of demand, again going back to the previous introduction of economics, that I have talked about, that there is a section of economic theory which is known as consumer theory, means the theory which pertains to the consumption as an economic activity. So within that bracket of theory, the consumption theory have had the first very important theory, which largely is the price theory, and that price determination process requires two countervailing forces, which demand and supply. So this is something which we need to look at first, beginning with the concept of demand. How, what is the concept of demand? So concept of demand could be explained as wants plus purchasing power. Demand could be understood as wants plus purchasing power. What do we mean by wants? Wants is basically what you want to have, and purchasing power means that you should have money to buy it. So that wants plus purchasing power is basically being reflected as an exchange happening in the economy and a price getting settled on at, let's say, P. We'll look at a graph afterwards. So concept of demand is demand could also be looked at as a willingness to pay. That basically means what you are really interested in paying or capable of paying. Then you have, since it is a market, and you are not only talking about demand, whenever you talk about market, you need to talk about supply as well. So willingness to sell could also be considered as, getting reflected as a demand in the market. You can look at demand as a, schedule of supply and demand. So basically, when you look at the data like table reporting demand, which comes out of basically market research. So it's the demand schedule which we really look at, which comes out as a market research, are not basically what you call the realistic demand, but it is a sort of estimated demand. So that there is the way there you can look at demand as a vector of price in one column of the table, and corresponding vector of quantities being demanded in the market in other vector and other column of the table. So that combination of Q star and P star, which we call as market equilibrium, I will show you that market equilibrium in the next slide. So the concept of demand can also be understood as a market phenomenon. So what do we mean by market phenomenon? What is basically here being explained demand being explained as a market phenomenon? So there are two, three things to think about. One is that scarcity, this interaction of demand and supply is basically this interaction of demand and supply in the market is basically what it is reflecting is that availability of something and the scarcity of something. So what I mean to say that demand somehow is sort of index of availability of something. Demand is availability. If demand in a way is the inverse of a reflection of scarcity of commodity. So that is another way we can look at demand. Since we are talking about market again and again, so we should look at the definition of market. What is market? So I have earlier also talked about it, that market is basically an institution. Whenever we call it institution, what do we mean by institution? Institution is set of law, set of rules, which is being followed very strictly, very positively. basically these market is a type of institution where and that market as an institution, what it performs is an economic activity which is exchange, and that exchange happens between buyers and sellers. This concept of market looks like more of as a very very physical real market, whereas there are n number of market today which are virtual, and let's say there are another sort of what you call name and types of market. So that we will look at. What I will do in next, when I was talking about that demand as a market phenomenon, I said that market reflects the degree of scarcity of each commodity through its price. So what is price? Price comes out of market equilibrium. Let's look at the market equilibrium. So market equilibrium, I have prepared the slide, but I could not share it on time, so I'm sorry. I will later on share it, and he can circulate it to all of you through email or something, and you can look at it and you will find it very related to what I am talking about. Okay, so concept of equilibrium is basically that the exchange which is taking place into the market, what sort of operation is happening in the market? What are the operations that are happening? So there are two countervailing sort of forces. One is supply and another is demand. Countervailing sort of forces are interacting with each other, and that if we try to depict both of these as what you call a curve through graphs, I think you have to know some fundamentals. One is that when we draw a demand curve, it should be negatively sloped. So basically, if you put, I am telling if students can try to draw it, it would be fine. And otherwise, it is a very easily available curve. You can look at anywhere. So point is that you put a quantity demanded on axis X, and you put price on axis Y, okay, and then you draw a negatively sloped line, straight line, touching, joining X and Y, okay. So this line is a demand curve. Why demand curve is negatively sloped and all other things has other theory in behind of it. So that we are not right now explaining, because we have to stick to our topic. But of course, we should know that why actually this is happening. Okay, then when we are looking at concept of market equilibrium, before looking at market equilibrium, this equilibrium, we should of course look at the concept of equilibrium itself. Equilibrium as a concept, what it is. So let me try to start with saying that concept of equilibrium itself is a dubious in nature. So it is not something which is very realistically thought of, because in real sense, economy always is in dynamic situation, or our life is in always in is in dynamic situation. So I don't think that there is any equilibrium exist as such. So what is it? It is a theoretical equilibrium which is being depicted by interaction of demand and supply. You are arriving at a theoretical price, and this is all theory. And how you implicate it in the market is altogether different. Some of the commerce student might be really feeling it to be very, what you call, very differently taught, because when they look at demand, supply, and all that definitions, they look at it very differently. So I think for today, we can stop here, and we can take a few questions, and then if I think that we should proceed for some more discussion, then I will go on. Mathematically, since we are talking about demand, mathematically, गणित को लेकर के इकोनॉमिक्स में जो अर्थशास्त्र में जो गणित का यूज उपयोग हुआ है, तो मैथमेटिकली वी कैन लुक एट डिमांड फंक्शन एज क्यू इक्वल्स टू फंक्शन ऑफ क्यू इक्वल्स टू एफ ऑफ लेट्स से पी वाई टी. So what are these two? Q is the quantity demanded in the market, and which is the Q, quantity demanded is the function of so many things. What are those? Let's say first is price of that commodity. What is second is taste for that commodity. What is third? Income is also important, that what kind of commodity we could demand. So likewise, you can put more and more. Yeah, thank you for putting that function. So the so likewise, we can put all that and we can write it as a function, and function is a mathematical representation. So basically what we are doing, that by writing down this function, we are writing demand function, which we can use for further inquiry in terms of, let's say, if we have demand function, likewise we have supply function, and we can use those functions to draw those straight lines having positive and negative slope, demand having negative slope and supply having positive slopes, getting interacted and what you call boiling down equilibrium price P star. I think economics student can make sense of what is P star, because they are being taught from the beginning that P star is equilibrium price, Q star is equilibrium quantity. So this all you know. So for I think now it's almost done.